spiritual, which you're going to do with me in the bishop's office. And then we're going to set some goals that are physical that you guys are going to do with the Brother and Sister Wolfgram in the culture hall. And then Sister Otwafi and Sister Banford, they're going to help you guys with your goals when it comes to your intellectual goals, like education, careers, things like that. Any goal you write with this pen, you will accomplish. So today, I want you guys to take full advantage of learning what a goal is, how to set a goal, and your leaders are going to be here to help you guys with those things.
Assignment tonight is the physical goals. So I want everybody, if you can, to write in your book, the very first thing, put physical goals. Some physical goals. Because every goal that you're going to do tonight, we're going to write it in your book. Why do you think it's important to write it down?
To remember it.
To remember it? Okay. That's a good idea. I think another good reason why you should write it down is so that you actually are held accountable to do it. Okay, physical goals, and then underneath it, you guys can put whatever you want, and I'm going to kind of talk about physical goals. Now, as you can see, I'm not so physically in shape, but this is just not about health, it's also about just anything you can do physically. So, the second person cannot shoot the ball until the first person shoots.
Okay.
So there's two balls.
Okay, you guys ready?
You guys look at this portion of your goal book to really try to accomplish it, okay? This is mainly for you, it's for your success, and we hope that giving you a few ideas will help you kind of, I don't know, reach out and try to learn something new. So I want to tell you guys, I love you guys, and I hope that when you guys go to the other stations, you guys write all the goals that you really, your heart desires. So leave that with you in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Learn basic job skills that you can use now and later. Attend cultural events. Learn another language. Become more self-reliant. And then learn and practice principles of self-discipline.
I think intellectual goals are very important. Sometimes life doesn't take you where you want it to go. You know, like, plans change all the time. And that's part of the reason why it's so important to keep, like, intellectual goals, because I feel like in my life, so I personally went to college for 4 years. I was trying to get a psychology degree and I dropped out, and I became a mom, got married, became a mom, and now knowing what I know now, I'm like, I would have never gone to college. Because the cool thing about this generation is that you don't have to get a formal education to be successful in life. There's so many routes. It just depends on what you want to do and what your aspirations and who you want to become.
Me and Alexis were talking earlier, and my three older kids, I felt like I was super hard. Like, I drove education into them. They had to have a 3.5 GPA or higher. And I just realized with each, I guess as I got older, like Alexa said, I realized that that's not the only avenue to succeed, you know? I think just finding a passion, finding something that you enjoy doing, and then getting resources to reach that goal.
You're giving me opportunity to share, but just like my dad was saying,
I'm the oldest of my siblings, so the way education worked in our home is they did not play around. So we took education very seriously, which led me to want to go to college. Even though they did set up the path, they ultimately left it up to me if I wanted to attend university or not. And I genuinely did. So I went to BYU. I first declared my major as communications marketing. And then at the end of my freshman year, I was married and had a child already. So just like Alexis, I decided to take advantage of the education on homemaking and how to be a mother. And so I studied family education, and that's what I ended up getting my degree in. But after graduation, I had the hardest time trying to find work in that specific study. I think there's no better time than to dive into a passion project. Just like what Brother and Sister Wolfgram were sharing out there, whatever your interest in your craft is, don't ignore it. And you may not know how to get on the avenue to like dive into that, but it's gonna come later on. And that's what happened to me this year. I've always had such an interest and passion in one, hearing other people's stories, and two, capturing people do what they love. And so, as most of you guys know, Bishop, he's one of the assistant coaches at West High. And so I just thought to take my passion to that program and try to find an avenue with that, and be able to create a social media platform for their West football team. And you can learn how to consecrate that, and if you take it to God, he will really help guide you to use that talent if that's really a passion of yours. So I was able to do that with that West High program, and now I'm doing it with a couple of companies. But that was one of my goals this year, is to learn how to consecrate my talent for Heavenly Father. So I'm now trying to bring that here to the Lord, and I want to make social media like a part of bringing our ward together, keeping them updated, showing the different personalities and the different stories that are here in our wards, just to share our life, not only within our own ward, but to our stake and to our state and just everyone who watches our page. So.